गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग. सो इन आवर लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट कंडक्टर्स एंड इंसुलेटर्स. देर आर सम ऑब्जेक्ट्स दैट अलाउ द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू पास थ्रू देम, बट देर आर सम सर्टेन ऑब्जेक्ट्स विच डू नॉट अलाउ द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू पास थ्रू देम. बेस्ड ऑन दैट वी आर क्लासिफाई द ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन टू टू टाइप्स. वन इज कंडक्टर्स and the another is insulators, right? And almost all the Ohm's law, we are already stated the Ohm's law, and some a constant that is introduced by Ohm is known as resistance. George Simon Ohm introduced a constant. That constant of proportionality is known as resistance, and the resistance is the ability of an object to resist the flow of current through an electric circuit. Almost all these portions are covered in our last class. So once again I want to recollect all these points. After that we can move to the next topic. What are the factors on which this resistance depends? So before that we can state what is the difference between the conductors and the insulators. So starting with the Alna Rose, I request all of you to please switch on your videos. Those who are sitting in physics class, please switch on your videos. Revu, please switch on your video. Okay, so the question is to Alna Rose, distinguish between conductors and insulators. Alna, unmute and say what is the difference between conductors and the insulators. The same question to Gauri.
The substances that are allowed to pass current through them are known as conductors. And the substances that do not allow to pass current through them are called insulators.
Okay, the substances that allow the electricity to pass through them are called conductors. And one more point you can add along with that of conductors. Conductors obeys Ohm's law. Okay, add one more point along with that of the conductors. Conductors obeys Ohm's law. Okay, conductors obeys Ohm's law. So the next question, what do you mean by insulators? Question is to Navaneet. Can you give some examples for conductors and insulators?
Ma'am, conductors, metal.
Metal, almost all the type of metals are comes under conductors. What about insulators?
Rubber and glass.
Rubber and glass, rubber, wood, glass, etc. are insulators. So my next question, students, what do you think, does the insulators obey the Ohm's law? Is it is obeys the Ohm's law? No, insulators does not obeys the Ohm's law. Only the conductors are obeys the Ohm's law, and the insulators are not obeying the Ohm's law. So this is the difference between conductors and insulators. Okay. Then what do you mean by resistance? Question is to Angelo. What do you mean by resistance? Resistance. No idea. Raya, can you define what you mean by resistance?
Ability to resist the flow of current.
Yes, very good. It is the ability to resist the flow of current. From this term itself, you can form a definition for resistance. Resistance means resist something that is resist the flow of current. It is the ability to resist the flow of current through an electric circuit is known as resistance. Nobel, what is the SI unit of resistance? SI unit of resistance.
Ohm.
Very good. It is Ohm. Ohm is the SI unit of resistance. I request all of you, please switch on your videos. Okay. So students, today we are going to discuss the next topic, that is factors affecting the value of resistance. So all of you write the next heading, factors affecting the value of resistance. Factors affecting the value of resistance. Okay, so let us see what are the factors affecting the value of resistance with the help of an activity. In your textbook, page number 206, activity 12.3. Here we are going to do this activity 12.3 in your textbook, page number 206. All of you take the activity 12.3 of page number 206. So based on this activity, we can form an idea or we can discuss what are the factors that is affecting the value of resistance. So from this figure, from the circuit that is given in the page number 206, can you identify what are the components are required to do this activity? What are the electrical components or electrical devices are required to do this activity? All of you take your textbook, page number 206. Page number 206, activity 12.3. Identify the electrical devices that is needed to do this activity. I will call your names, then you can say. So the question is to Kshetra. What are the electrical devices that here we needed to do this activity?
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, now it is good afternoon, Fizan. Good afternoon. Kshetra, page number 206. Identify the electrical devices that here we needed to do this activity. Who is ready to say the answer? Those who are ready to say the answer can raise your hands.
Switch.
Yes, very good. Switch is needed. Then
ammeter.
Ammeter, very good. Ammeter, switch. Then anything else?
Cell or battery.
Okay, here we are using, they are only using cell. Okay, the combination of cells are called a battery, but here they are only use an electric cell. So electric cell, ammeter and switch. And here we leave a gap between them. In that gap, we are used to connect some conductors. Okay, so now let us see the activity 12.3 of page number 206. So in order to do this activity, here we are need some equipments. One is cell. So here we have the cell. Then ammeter also needed. What about our ammeter? Okay, so here we have an ammeter. Anything is here other than this? Okay, I think switch is also here. Switch instead of key, here they are using a switch. Okay, we can use the key. Okay, so we can use the cell. Here the cell is there. Okay, now it's enough. Almost all the components are here. Now we can do the activity. So what is the use of ammeter here in the circuit, students? Is there any particular use?
Yes,
it is used to measure the current. Very good. It is used to measure the current. Okay. Now we are used to connect all these components. And ammeter is always connected in series or parallel to a circuit. How the ammeter is connected? Yes, it's always connected in series to an electric circuit. Now we are going to connect all these apparatus. So here, the negative terminal of the cell is connected to here. One terminal of the cell is connected and here we are leaving a gap between them. It is connected to a key. Then it is connected to the next end of the ammeter. Okay, so this is the connection. The connection is over. Now here we are leaving some space between them. We can name it as XY. In between the gaps, here we are going to connect some conductors. So I will give you the conductors here, or the materials. Here we are used to connect some materials in that gap. And we are going to measure the corresponding current that is passing through these materials whenever they are connected to the circuit. The first material is a nichrome wire. Nichrome wire. And its length is 5 meters. Okay. Then the second material that we are used to connect, again the nichrome wire with a different dimension. Now the length is doubled. Can you guess the length now? So initially we are used a length with 5 meters. Now we are going to use length with the 10 meters. Good. 10 meters. Again, in the third case, we are going to connect the same nichrome wire. Its length is equal to 5 meters. Okay. But it's with a large area of cross section. 5 meters, that is, its area is increasing. The nichrome wire's area of cross section is increasing, means here we are using a thicker nichrome wire compared to that of the first case. So area is equal to, we can take it as 20 meters square. Thicker nichrome wire. And the fourth one is entirely different material. Here we are going to take a copper wire. Copper wire of same length, L is equal to 5 meters. Okay. So these are the materials that we are, instead of meter, we can convert it into centimeter. 10 centimeter, 5 centimeter, centimeter square, here also 5 centimeter. Not meter, centimeter. So here we are consider the materials like nichrome wire of 5 centimeter length. In the second case, we are going to connect the nichrome wire with the length is equal to 10 centimeter. And in the third case, here also we are using a nichrome wire with the same length as that of the first case. But the difference is, here we are using a thicker nichrome wire. In the first case, it is a thin nichrome wire. But in the second case, we are used to connect a thicker nichrome wire. Okay, with a large area of cross section. Then, the last case we are used to connect entirely different material. It is not nichrome, it is copper wire. So now we are going to connect these materials one by one into our circuit. So what is our first material? First material that we are used to connect here, it is a nichrome wire. Okay. So first we connect a nichrome wire of length L is equal to 5 centimeter. Nichrome wire of length is equal to 5 centimeter. Now the circuit is closed. Here we have the key. Key is in the closed state. So the circuit, the current is flowing through the circuit. Then here we have an ammeter to measure the value of the current. And suppose if the value of the current is pointing towards this direction, can you identify the value of the current here?
4.
Here. I will measure the value. It is, for example, it is 0. Here it is 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, and 2.5. No, sorry. Between this 2.5 and here we have 3. So now the ammeter reading is towards here. What is this reading indicates?
One.
Okay. Ampere. So when we are connecting 1 ampere, very good, excellent. So here when we are connecting the nichrome wire with the length L is equal to 5 cm. Here we get the value of current. I is equal to, current is expressed in ampere. We get the current is equal to 1 ampere. Okay, the current is 1 ampere. Now we are going to replace this nichrome wire. We are going to replace the nichrome wire. And what is the second material that we are going to connect here?
Nichrome wire, but double the length.
Yes, very good. Nichrome wire with a double the length. So in your textbook, you can see a figure like this. So now the length of the nichrome wire is increases. It is increases to 10 cm. L is equal to 10 cm, but the material is the same. It is the nichrome wire, but its length is increases to 10 cm. Again, we repeat the same procedure. That is, we are used to measure the current that is flowing through the circuit when we are connecting a nichrome wire. L is equal to 10 cm. And this time, the ammeter reading is, or ammeter is pointed towards here. What is this value indicates?
0.5.
Very good. So here in the table, in the observation table, we can write, when we connect to the nichrome wire with a length L is equal to 10 cm, ammeter reading is 0.5. It is 0.5 ampere. What happens to the value of current? Is it is increase or decrease?
Decrease.
It is a decreases. Okay, it is decreases. Now we are going to connect our third material. What is our third material?
Nichrome wire.
It is nichrome wire with the length is same, L is equal to 5 cm as that of the first case. But what happens to the area?
Its thickness increases.
Yes, very good. Its thickness is increases. So here we are going to connect the third material, that is the nichrome wire. But its area is increases. Okay. That is, here we are used to connect a thicker nichrome wire. Here we are used to connect a thicker nichrome wire. The length is same, that is 5 cm, but the area of the nichrome wire is equal to, we can take it as 20 cm square. Same material, nichrome wire. And here also we repeat the same procedure. Here we are repeating the same procedure. The circuit is closed. Current is flowing through the circuit, and here we measure the value of the current. And during this time, here we have 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5. And during this time, the ammeter reading is here. Can you identify the value? What about the ammeter reading? Whenever we connect a nichrome wire, yes. When we correct connect, it is 2 ampere. Very good, very good. So here we can write the value. So when we connect a nichrome wire with a large area of cross section, A is equal to 20 cm square, we get a value of current that is equal to 2 ampere. Okay. Now what happens to the value of current? Does it is increase or decrease?
It increases.
It is again increases. Okay. Now the last case. Here we are going to connect the last material. What is that last material, Anjali?
A copper wire.
Yes, it is a copper wire. Here we are going to connect a copper wire. That is an entirely different material. Okay. So here we are going to connect another material. That is copper wire. With the L is equal to same. The same length, 5 cm. But the material is entirely different. It is a copper wire. Okay, so now the circuit is closed. The current is flowing through the circuit. Again, we repeat the same procedure. We measure the value of current. And during this time, the ammeter reading is towards this direction. What about the value of current in ammeter? Value of current in ammeter?
3 ampere.
Yes, it is 3 ampere. It is 3 ampere. Okay. So these are the observation that we made from this activity. So here we are using S.
1 minute, can I write this?
Yes.
I'm can 1 minute, can I write this?
Yes. All of you, please switch on your videos. Devasena. Okay. So students, in this activity here we are consider four different types of materials. Here we are going to find out what are the factors affecting the value of resistors. So in order to describe the factors that is affecting the value of resistors, here we are doing an activity. For that we consider four different materials. Not four different materials, the first three materials are the same with a different dimension, and the fourth one is an entirely different material. Okay. So the first one is a nichrome wire with a length is equal to 5 cm, and the second one is again a nichrome wire but with a different dimension, that is length is equal to 10 cm. Here we double the length of the material. And in the third case, here also we are using a nichrome wire with a length L is equal to 5 cm, but the area of cross section, it is 20 cm². That is, here we are using a thick nichrome wire. And the last case, we use an entirely different material, that is a copper wire with the same length, L is equal to 5 cm. And here we measure the current that is flowing through the circuit when we connect these materials into the electric circuit. Okay, so now we can analyze this table. So students, can you identify in which case large current is flowing through the circuit?
Ma'am, through copper wire.
Yes. Now only you need to compare up to the table 3. You don't need to be focused on the fourth case. Compare the first three cases.
Yes. Nichrome wire with more thickness.
Yes, when we connect the nichrome wire with the more thickness, when we connect the nichrome wire with the more thickness, more current will flow through the circuit, that is equal to 2 ampere. So my next question, in which case less current will flow occurs through the electric circuit?
And as the length of the nichrome wire increases.
Yes, whenever the length of the nichrome wire increases, when L is equal to 10 cm, that is in the second case, the current that is flowing through the circuit is less. Okay, so from this we can form some conclusions. Can you recall what you mean by Ohm's law? Recall or can you state the Ohm's law?
At constant temperature, the two ends of a conductor are directly potential difference of two ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the current flowing through it.
Okay, at a constant temperature, the potential difference across the ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the current that is flowing through the circuit. Then Minha, what is the equation for calculating the Ohm's law? Mathematical representation for Ohm's law. Minha. Say louder.
V is
equal to IR. This is the mathematical representation for Ohm's law. Okay. Then again, who is here? Ahlam. How we can calculate resistance from this equation? Because here we are going to describe the factors affecting the resistance of the materials. So how we can calculate the resistance from this equation? Rearrange the equation. V is equal to IR. Then how we can calculate the resistance?
R is equal to V by I.
Very good. R is equal to V divided by I. Now, we can focus this equation. Students, here the resistance and the current is inversely proportional to each other, right? Here the resistance and the current is inversely proportional to each other. What do you mean by this term, inversely proportional?
Just
if resistance increases, the flow of current will decrease.
Very good. Very good. And vice versa. Inversely proportional means, if one quantity increases, another quantity decreases, right? If one quantity increases, another quantity decreases. So here the resistance is inversely proportional to the resistance, which implies if the resistance increases, the rate of flow of current through the circuit is decreases, right? So again, we can move to this our table. So in the third case, that if we are connecting a nichrome wire with a large area of cross section, what happens to the value of current? In the third case, if you are connecting a nichrome wire with a large...
Increases.
Yes, the value of current is increases. So my question is this. what happens to the value of resistance in this case?
Decreases.
Yes, it is decreases. So whenever the nichrome wire with a large area of cross section is connecting to the circuit, current increases. Here the value of the current is increases, but according to Ohm's law, we can say that the resistance is decreases. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Because according to the Ohm's law, we know that the resistance is inversely proportional to current. That is, if the value of the resistance increases, the current flowing through the circuit is decreases, and vice versa. That is, if the flow of current through the circuit is increases, then the resistance offered by the circuit is decreases. So here in this activity, we can see that the third case, there is a large amount of current is flowing through the circuit. That is 2 ampere current is flowing through the circuit. So in such case, we can say the resistance offered by the circuit is decreases. At the same time, you must kept in mind, what is the definition for resistance? What is the definition for resistance?
Ability of the
current to flow through the electricity.
Very good, excellent. It is the ability to resist the flow of current through a circuit is known as resistance. So if the current flow is occurs through the circuit without any problem, so we can say that in such a case the resistance is decreases. So from this activity we get one factor affecting the value of resistance. What is that factor? One factor that is affecting the value of resistance. What is that? Here the nichrome wire with? Yes, excellent. So here we are the area of cross section. So first factor, here our heading, factors affecting the value of resistance. Factors depends on resistance. Factors depends on resistance. What is the first factor we got from this activity? It is the area of cross section. Area of cross section of material. Area of cross section of material. And can you find the relation between the area of cross section of material and that of the resistance? Whenever the area increases, what happens to the resistance?
Decreases.
Very good. So here you can note, whenever the area increases, that is area increases, resistance decreases. Area increases, then resistance decreases. So this is the first factor that is affecting the value of resistance. Area increases, resistance decreases. Now, we can find the second factor from the table. Here, in which case the rate of flow of current is decreases?
As the length increases.
Yes, as the length increases, the value of the current is decreases. Here, we get only 0.5 ampere. Whenever we connect the nichrome wire with a length 10 centimeter to the circuit, we get an current is equal to 0.5 ampere. That is, the value of the current is decreases. So what can be the value of resistance here?
Increases.
Here the value of the resistance is large, or it is increases. That is, if the current decreases, then the value of the resistance is increases. So what is the next factor affecting the value of resistance?
Length of the conductor.
Very good. It is the length of the conductor. The second factor that is affecting the value of resistance is length of the conductor. Length of the conductor. So whenever you write the factors affecting the value of resistance, you must mention how these two factors are related. Okay. So whenever the length of the conductor increases, what happens to the resistance? When length increases, which implies
decreases.
Resistance decreases. Length increases, resistance decreases.
Ma'am.
Okay. Yes.
Resistance increases.
Whenever the length increases, resistance also. Yes, very good. So you are already listen here. Anyway, I'm happy. Whenever the length increases, resistance also increases. Right.
Length.
Okay, I will explain it here once again. So in the second case, whenever the length increases, the value of the current is decreases, Fizan. Right? The value of the current is decreases. But what happens to the resistance? What happens to the value of resistance?
It increases,
right? Whenever the length of the material is increases, that is here we are using L is equal to 10 centimeter. That is length of the material increases, it gives a current of only 0.5 ampere, very small amount of current, that is 0.5 ampere. So the value of current is decreases. So in such a case, we can say that the value of resistance will be more. Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the second factor affecting the value of resistance is length of the material, length of the conductor or length of the material. That is, whenever the length increases, the resistance is also increases. Here we are only concentrate on resistance, not the value of current. Whenever the length increases, the resistance is also increases. Okay. Yes.
And second factor.
That's second factor is length of the material or length of the conductor. And how this length of the conductor is related to the resistance? When length increases, resistance is also increases. Or we can say that length is directly proportional to resistance. L is directly proportional to resistance. Small letter L. What about the first case? Area of cross section, is it directly proportional or indirectly proportional?
Indirectly
proportional. So we can write the resistance is indirectly proportional to area of cross section. R is inversely proportional to 1 by A. R is inversely proportional to 1 by A. Okay. Now, one more factor is there. Now here we have copper. When we connect an entirely different material, copper wire, what about the value of current here? Compare with that of the other cases. The girls are remaining silent here. What happens?
Okay. Increases now.
Adulya, what about the value of current when we are connecting copper wire?
Increases.
Yes, it possesses a large value of current. And what is the value of current in the present case when we are connecting a copper wire? Yes? Shania?
3 ampere.
It is 3 ampere. That is, we get a large value of current if we are changing the material, copper wire. So here we can say that the another factor that is depends on the value of resistance is nature of the material. Depending upon the nature of the material, the value of resistance is also varies. Okay, so here we can say that copper wire possesses a less value of resistance as compared to that of the nichrome wire. That is why the value of the current is 3 ampere. Here the value of the current is 3 ampere, which means it possesses a large value of the current. So here the value of I is large. Then what about the value of resistance offered by the copper? It will be less as compared to that of the nichrome wire. So here we can say the next factor that is depends upon the resistor is the third factor, nature of the material. Nature of the material. Different material possesses different resistance. Nature of the material. So the value of resistance is entirely different for different types of materials. Okay. Now one more factor is there, that is temperature. Temperature. There is no experimental proof for that of the in order to show that how this temperature is from this activity, we cannot say that how this temperature is affected the value of resistance. And temperature is directly proportional to resistance. That is, whenever the temperature increases, the value of the resistance is also increases. Temperature is directly proportional to resistance. That is, temperature increases, the value of the resistance is also increases. So there are mainly four factors are there that is affecting the value of resistance. Okay, so once again we can recall all these factors. So starting with Melita, what are the factors that is affecting the value of resistance? All of you please switch on your videos. Yes, Melita, I can hear. Can you say it louder? Melita, are you there? Okay, I'm so sorry. Yes, Melita. What are the factors affecting the value of resistance?
Nature of the material.
Nature of the material. Okay, then?
Length of the conductor.
Length of the conductor.
Temperature.
Temperature. One more factor. Rohan. Okay, Melita, what is one more factor is there which is affecting the value of resistance? What is that? Can you recall all the factors that is affecting the value of resistance, Rohan? Try to recall all the factors.
Yes.
Yes. What are the factors affecting the value of resistance? What are the different factors affecting the value of resistance? Here we are describing some factors through this activity. We are describing some factors that is affecting the value of resistance. What are they? Okay, I'm so sorry. The question is to Revu. What are the factors affecting the value of resistance? Unmute and say.
Yes, ma'am.
Factors affecting the value of resistance.
Ma'am, areas.
Area of cross-section. So one more factor is there, that is area of cross-section. So students, there are mainly four factors are there that is affecting the value of resistance. Karthik, can you recall all the factors that is affecting the value of resistance?
Length.
Length.
Area of cross-section.
Area of cross-section.
Temperature.
Then?
Nature of material.
Temperature.
Then nature of material.
Yes. One more factor is there. What's that?
I said one more.
Nature of the material. All right. Okay. Then Ilana, how the length of the conductor is depends on resistance. How they are relate to each other. Ilana Rose, how the length of the conductor is depends on the resistance. I can hear. I think some audio problems are there. Okay, the same question to Navaneet. How the length of the conductor is depends upon the resistance of the material.
Ma'am, length increases, then resistance also increases.
Very good. If the length of the material or length of the conductor increases, then the resistance is also increases. So the next question is to Srihari. how the area and that of the resistance depends.
When the area increases, the resistance decreases.
Very good. If the area increases, the value of the resistance is decreases. The next question to Lena. How the physical quantity temperature related to that of the resistance?
It is directly proportional to resistance.
Yes, the temperature is directly proportional to resistance. That is, whenever the temperature increases, the resistance offered by the material is also increases. And one more factor is there, that is nature of the material. We cannot exactly say that whenever the nature of the material increases, the resistance is also increases. We cannot say like that. We can say the resistance, the value of the resistance is different for different materials. Okay, so if the material is different, in each case we know that we are not only used to the nichrome wire or copper, sometimes we may be used the aluminium or silver. In that cases also they possess their resistance value. So depending upon the nature of the material, the value of the resistance is also varies. Is it clear? Clear or not?
Clear.
Yes or no? Okay. So here we have an equation. Depending upon the factors affecting the value of resistance, we know that the first factor is length. Okay. And how the length is related to resistance? Is it is directly proportional or indirectly proportional?
Directly
proportional.
Proportional.
Okay. So R is directly proportional to L. And what about the area of cross section? Inversely proportional. R is inversely proportional to 1 by A. So here we have two equations. R is directly proportional to length of the material and R is inversely proportional to the area of cross section. Now we can compare these two equations. So it becomes R is proportional to L by A. Here we are comparing the equation 1 and equation 2. So we get R is proportional to L by A. And physics, we have a tendency to replace this proportionality sign. So here also we are going to replace this proportionality sign by introducing a constant. That is R is equal to rho into L by A. And here this rho is known as the proportionality constant. It is the resistivity. Resistivity. So from the factors affecting the value of resistance, here we are deriving an equation for resistance. Here we know that R is directly proportional to length of the conductor. R is inversely proportional to area of cross section. So by comparing these two equations, we can write R is proportional to L by A. To replace this proportionality sign, here we introduce a constant. That constant is known as resistivity. So here the equation is R is equal to rho. How it is pronounced? Rho. Okay, this is a Greek letter that is representing the resistivity. R is equal to rho into L by A. Okay, we can discuss about this equation in our next class. R is equal to rho into L by A. So before winding up the class, here, where is Rohan? Can you say any one factor that is depends upon the resistor? Rohan. Any one factor that is depending upon the value of resistance.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I did not get question.
Anyone, here we discuss four factors that depends on the value of resistance. So yeah. Can you say any one factor that is depends upon the value of resistor?
Am I know.
Okay, Fizan.
I'm cross section of length.
Yes.
I'm cross section of length.
Cross section of length is incorrect. It is wrong. Area of cross section and another factor is length. Okay, children, so with this we